Hi, and welcome to this interview preparation series. In the series of videos, what we are going to do is discuss the most frequently asked 30 questions each from Amazon, Google, Facebook, and Microsoft. This will help you understand the type and difficulty level of the question asked by these companies. I am not just going to give you solutions here, rather, we will work on the strategy that we have discussed earlier in how to crack the coding interview video. If you have not seen the video, I would highly recommend you to go and watch it once. You can find the link below in the description. I would suggest you to spend 30 days with me and you can see the difference that you have created in yourself. Come here every day and spend 2 hours with me. Start solving 2 to 3 questions in the same sequence that I have discussed. If you get stuck, come and watch the solution and try again yourself. Let's start solving our first question without wasting much time. This is an easy question on LeetCode, but asked more than 100 times in Fortune 500. If you are not a premium member on LeetCode, then you can see the number of likes and guess the importance of the problem. This problem has around 14,000 likes, which makes it an important one for you to solve. So, what approach should we take to solve this problem? Remember, I already have said you, if you don't come up with any strategy, then there is a higher chance of failure. We will invest our first 10 minutes in reading the question and coming up with a brute force approach. Let me explain you the question first. You are given an array and a target value. What you have to do is, you have to find 2 numbers in an array such that they sum up to a given target value. Think of the brute force solution first. You can solve this question by fixing one element in an array and searching for the target element in the remaining array. This approach will take big O of n square time and constraint space. So let's see if this works or not. Throughout the series, we'll solve the questions in Python programming language. So let's start and solve this question using brute force approach. As I've already said you, this question will take O of n square, time complexity and constraint space. We'll run the outer loop from I equals to 0 to I equals to n minus 1, where n is the length of the array. We'll run the inner loop from I plus 1 to n minus 1. And finally, we will see that if the value, means the value at arrayth at ith index equals to target minus value at jth index. And if this happens, then you found your index and that is I comma j, and then return that index. That is a simple brute force approach you have to do. But see what's the time complexity of this problem. Let's submit it and see the time complexity, the time this problem took to execute. You can see the time complexity is 6040 milliseconds, and that's really a huge time taken by this problem. So we have to somehow reduce this time, right? So what should be our next approach and how should we optimize this problem so that we reduce our time complexity? So next, what we are going to do is we are going to think what are the things that need to be optimized in the following problem so that we can get a better runtime and efficient solution for this. So let's start. Next, let's try to optimize this brute force solution. What should be your approach to optimize this problem? Think, can we trade between time and space? What actually we are trying to achieve in the second loop? Isn't we just searching for an element in an array in our second loop? Can we do this search in a constant time? If yes, then our solution will reduce to big O of n time, that is linear time complexity, and that will make a huge difference. That I'll show you the difference, okay? Remember, that will make really a huge difference. So yes, we can search an element in constant time using hash map or dictionary in Python. The amortized time complexity of searching an element in a hash table is big O of n, that is constant. Let's see how we can solve this problem in big O of n time complexity. Let's create a dictionary, Python dictionary named object to store the key values for searching purpose. And remember how we are going to store the values is like we are going to store the numbers in the array and as a key and value as index. And then what we are going to do is this time we are going to use enumerate function to iterate over the array for I, comma, val in enumerate arrays. Here I will be the index of the element and val will be the value at that index. Next, we are going to check if target minus value element is present in the object or not, that is in the Python dictionary or not. If it is present in Python dictionary, that means we found the object and we just have to return the index of that. So return I, comma, the index of that element and that we have stored as a value in this particular key, target minus val. Otherwise, just add the object to the array. Otherwise, just add the object to the dictionary. And we can simply do this by object val equals to I. And now let's run this problem. Let's submit this and see. You can see that this problem has been solved in 88 milliseconds. And earlier, it was around 6,040 milliseconds. So you can see the huge difference, right? It's the difference of around 5,900 or something, right? So it's really a huge difference. Hope you are able to understand that we are trading between time and space. And also you can see that the time reduced from 6,000 milliseconds to 8,000 milliseconds. And that's really a huge difference. In the next video, we'll discuss another question from the list that we have shown you earlier in this video. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you want me to continue making these videos, please help me by subscribing to my YouTube channel and press the bell icon so that whenever I upload new videos, you get notified about it. Happy learning!